270 क्यूसेक दिल्ली वाटर सप्लाई प्रोजेक्ट यूपी जल निगम, एंड द थर्ड केस स्टडी विच विल बी अ केबल स्टेट ब्रिज. वी विल टच ऑन केबल स्टेट ब्रिज, एक्स्ट्राडोस ब्रिज विच वी फाइंड अराउंड अवर प्लेसेस नाउ इन इंडिया, एंड फाइनली आई विल शेयर फ्यू टिप्स विच विल मेक योर प्रोजेक्ट वर्क ईजी. And when you join your first organization, it will give you a confidence. So with this 9 points, we will start our presentation. What makes Bridge team? Bridge stand not only because of its design, but there is someone we call construction engineer who turns drawing into reality. We need authority who invest money, like National Highway Authority, state bridge departments, and we have a final stage of bridge, but to build we require temporary work. So we have engineers who work behind the scene to make design of temporary works. Then we need a project management consultant who does a planning and progress of, who maintains a, like he gives all required approval, independent design review consultant. We require health and safety engineer who ensures safety of worker making this bridge, cost control engineer, contract and subcontract engineer who will work about finance and giving subcontract work to small contractors. To connect how theory, what we learn at university is important for you when you enter into the field. Maxwell's shortest load path theorem, I want to touch. Truss, they take load by tension and compression. In this picture, I have shown compression members and tension members. Tension members with blue color. What Maxwell during 17th century, he gave this theorem, which we didn't learn at university. He said, you find out force in a tension member. This is my tension member, F. Know its length F, L. F into L. This will be for one member. We do this for all the tension members and do summation. Same exercise we will do with a compression member where our force will be FC and its length will be LC. FC into LC. We do summation of all this stuff together. And when you find a sum of these two numbers, if this number comes less, it is called most optimum truss, most optimum structure. The design process of bridge involves three stages: analysis, design. Design means how much reinforcement or which steel section to be put. And the third one, detailing. Detailing of a joint, anchors, different components. So when we have a determinate structure, we can find out force in a member without its structural property. You agree with me? When you have an indeterminate truss, you require stiffness of a member. So we found two quantities. If this quantity comes the least, it is optimum configuration. I was curious. I wanted to find like what 17th century Maxwell informed. Is it true? And can we utilize in our real life application? I took a span and I want to transfer now load W to both the bank on either side. I came up with a truss. I kept depth, span. So here again, I have a blue members in a tension and other member in a compression. I have a force at the center. So if we want to do optimization study, we have to change some parameter. So I kept depth of a girder same. Only thing which I could play was I can move this point outward or inward. So this is only one variable with me. Span, I have a constant. I want to keep depth of a truss constant. So only the variable which I had to play around, it was moving this point outward or inward. So when I move this point outward, inward, I will get one variable, which is length of this member, I will call L1, and length of this member L2. So this was only one variable I had in this optimization study, L1 over L2. I did, or I can call A over B. Here, this picture shows which are the members under compression, C for compression, T tension. So what Maxwell informed, you find out force in member F1, that we will call F1, and its length L1, F6, L6, F8, L8, and this member is compression, F12, L12, F5, L5. So we do for all compression summation, we will have one number, we will call X, summation F compression, L compression. And Y for all the tension members, similar thing we will do for tension member, F4, L4. And if this sum comes minimum, that will be optimum. So I did study with three numbers, 1.543, 1.618, and 1.752. Did forces in Excel to do this multiplication. We will do multiplication of F into L, find F into L, do summation. So for compression member, for first trial, we got 275. We will do same exercise with the tension member, 275. Here we find some magic, like compression and tension, the number is coming same. Second trial with the ratio 1.618. Third trial with 1.752. And finally, prepared summary, F into L for compression, F into L for tension, the sum is 555, 549, 552. So what Maxwell said, given you have minimum work done, it is most optimum configuration. And the most minimum work happened at 1.618. And this was a number which was invented in India. Yes, Aryabhatta invented zero, but the number which we call 1.618, Fibonacci number, it was invented in India, but European, Italian mathematician who traveled in this part of world, he took this learning and published book. And when we see our body, it has this golden ratio in it. So God wanted us to do minimum work. So how we can find golden ratio here? X over Y, it will come phi, 1.618. So Z over X will be golden ratio. X over Y, golden ratio. If I have this number, it will be 1.618 times Z. So this is the magic of structural engineering. Our body is also one structure which has members in tension and compression. So you will appreciate like what we learn at institute, it will make our foundation for doing a good design. And now you want to bisect, like why during 16th century this theorem was invented. We learn in a truss, like if I have a tension member, what is the work done? Half force into displacement. And if you want to find out displacement, we can get from strain, delta L. Strain is delta L over L. And we know E equals to stress upon strain. And if you connect this work done principle, you will find Maxwell, without this knowledge, he was true. By doing just force into length and finding summation, you can come up with most economical solution. The second topic, now we will jump into how bridge transfer it loads. It transfers, one is we call bending moment and shear, and another mechanism which we call tension and compression. Truss, like here, if you have a hockey team where all the players, they work their best, like the players who are striking the opponent or the team members who are saving the goals, that team will always win. So that happens in a truss. Can you see all the fibers are getting stressed to same level? So whenever you want to make a team which wins, which rises bigger span, it's all the members should transfer their force through axial compression or tension. And in flexure, what happens? Only extreme fibers are getting stressed. And when we design RCC, we like reinforcement takes tension and concrete takes compression, stress block. And lever arm plays biggest role in design. As you increase lever arm between the tension and compression force, you can take more moment. So these two principles we have to remember at this stage. We transfer the bending moment at the center, which we call, we have WL square over 8, this bending moment by push-pull mechanism, the lever arm. As you increase the lever arm, your force in a member will reduce. So there are two mechanisms by which we transfer the force. First, bending, shear, and compression tension. Now we will see on different type of bridges which take their load based on one of the principle. Ivan Kulibin, he was an engineer who built many arch bridges in Russia. This picture I took when I traveled to Moscow. And in Russia, Europe, early days, we'll find arch bridges because at that time we had stone masonry and just concrete was invented. So in arch bridges, we transfer our load. The arch takes load through axial compression, thrust, we call thrust. So we make piers and our vehicles will travel. So we have three types of arches. We call 3-inch arch, 2-inch and fixed arch. 3-inch arch is a determinate, 2-inch indeterminate. So it will give lesser deflections. But if you have a soil which is settlement type or a temperature, we go for 3-inch arch where the stresses due to temperature or due to settlement will not come into picture. And finally, fixed end arch for very large span. Now, Indian Railway building bridge which will connect us to different places, tourist destination in Jammu and Kashmir. It is Chenab and Anjikhad. It is arch bridge, steel arch bridge. So whenever you think about a problem of super long. And if you have a strong soil which can take this thrust, the solution will be arch bridge. Chenab, which has a span of 480 meter, Chenab bridge. Here I have taken one more picture from Moscow, which is 3-inch arch. Why we call 3-inch? First hinge at the center, at the end. So the load path here, we have a girder which bends and through bending and shear will transfer load to this pier head. It will give to compression to this pier, and from here it will get down. And finally, load will travel to the support. Closer picture of this bridge. Hinge. So what happens, why we call hinge? Because at hinge location, you have compression and tension both coming together. Your lever arm, we say ke moment equals to force into lever arm. Lever arm becomes zero. So at hinge, moment will be zero. Closer picture of hinge. Steel arch bridges, concrete arch, if you want to span steel bigger, and when you are in earthquake prone area where you want to reduce self weight of structure, we go for steel arch bridges. I believe we civil engineers, we do 3C. We create, collaborate, and conflict resolver. These are the 3C I strongly believe civil engineers do. Create, collaborate, and like whenever you take any assignment, any project, there will be always conflict. And you come up with a solution to resolve that conflict. So here in this bridge, they had initial thought to go for two hinge arch, but they found deflection more. So they came up with a solution to add additional member, which will take. So now here you have a lever arm. It will take compression tension. So it became a fixed end. So always be positive when you come into the industry. When you have a problem, you will always able to find solution for that problem. Just you have to keep thinking and remember your what you learned at university. So here we can see two members. The load will get transferred from girder secondary beam to pier, and finally here. Another view of this steel arch bridge. So we will now jump into the simple bridge system which transfer load by flexure and shear. Slab bridge, like small villages where we want to work with the small contractors, we make slab bridge where the load is getting transferred through bending and shear. So this concept will be useful for span up to 8 meter. And if you want to go longer, we go for continuous system. And when you go for continuous, you provide haunch, we call, to take that additional bending moment. So we don't increase our weight uniform, just we provide haunch at the support location. So we can go for continuous bridges. One more thing which we remembered when we are making a continuous bridge. If I want to make three span continuous bridge, and if I keep all the three span equal, I will end up with more hogging moment at the support. So what we do, we keep our end span 80% of internal span. So if this is my L, I will keep this point at L. What this 80% makes, the hogging moment in the end span is equals to, sorry, sagging moment in the end span equals to sagging moment here. So whenever we have a continuous bridge, we make end span 80% of the internal span. That will reduce material. So we have a slab bridge. Now, if you want to span more than 8 meter, say around 20 meter, 25 meter, as we said before, always moment, it is getting transferred through compression and tension. So by using a girder bridge, you have increased the lever arm. I consider my family as a girder bridge. Why? Because my wife takes all compression and I am a steel girder who takes tension. And our kids, they tie us together like a bracing. So here we have an independent role. Concrete takes compression, steel girder takes tension, and you have a lever arm between them which takes that moment. So we call girder and slab bridges. Here I have shown an example of steel girder. We can make reinforced concrete girder, pre-stress girder, pre-tension, post-tension. And whenever we have a composite girder, we provide shear stud to transfer the force between concrete and steel. If you want to span steel bigger, then solution is a box girder. What is the beauty of box girder? Due to its closed section nature, it has a tremendous, like when we build bridges, it will not happen like our live load will move at the center. Our live load can be at eccentric. It will be on a corner. So it is generating a torsion. So box section torsion rigidity is around 100 times open section, because box section we call torsional rigidity equals to this area, central line area into thickness. For open section, the torsional rigidity is just summation BT cube over 3. So whenever we have a long span or a curved bridge, the box section provides high rigidity. So I will give you a small problem which you can take as an assignment. Create a box ,8 meter, depth 2 meter, and thickness 0.4 meter. Find out its torsional rigidity. Depth, center line depth 2 meter, 8 meter, 0.4. And if I convert this as just I section, I can make this equivalent 0.4 on either side, so 0.8 and 8 meter this width, and find out torsional rigidity. From mathematics, you will know like box is 100 times torsionally rigid. And the third one, which I told, the winning hockey team, a truss where all fibers are stressed to same level, that we call F over A. So whenever we have a long span, we go for truss, like Howrah bridge. It is a truss configuration. The bridges across Brahmaputra River, truss bridges. One more configuration which we learn at university, portal frame. Here we have a 3-inch portal frame, 3 inch portal frame bridge. Closer view of a hinge which transfers axial thrust to foundation. Another closer view. The central hinge. One more example of portal frame bridge. So it can span bigger and it's optimum. Another view of one of a pedestrian portal bridge. Closer view of a hinge. Another beautiful bridge. If you have traveled to Mumbai, Thane, next to the line which goes from Thane to Kalwa, it has the bowstring arch bridge. One we have in Andhra Pradesh also. So here we have suspenders who take tension load up and it is getting travel through thrust down. And since we don't want to this will be become as a tension member, it will take the tension as we have provided roller bearing here. Thrust, which like as we said, moment is getting transferred into push pull, compression force, tension force. So we like this bottom member we call tie. So whenever we think about tie, it's a tension member. This one is a tension member, compression member. So this will take a large span because here all the members, they are taking load through axial compression or tension. And I remember like we learn in history, divide and rule. So what happened? We had 100 meter span, we divided into small parts. But as we cannot provide any support here, we provided suspenders. Suspenders takes this tension. And by dividing the bigger span, we could rule this span. So tied arch, bowstring bridges. We can divide bridges based on material of construction, reinforced concrete, pre-stressed concrete, and structural steel. So these are the three. Yes, we build like in olden days, engineers were making stone masonry. So that is also one of the construction material. But broadly, nowadays, we have three: reinforced concrete, pre-stressed concrete, and structural steel. So when we think about steel, it should be high, like concrete, we go for 40 cube strength, 40 MPa, up to 40, 60 MPa. The elevated corridor in Mumbai, it had 60 MPa concrete with microsilica. So by adding microsilica, we make concrete durable and increase its E, Young's modulus. So when you increase E, your creep and deflections are reduced. And in steel, which is one of the most important property, we look for Charpy impact test. In strength of material, we learn about Charpy impact test. So whenever we have a welded connection, we want our steel to be a ductile, not brittle, or like steel, the weakest thing is fatigue. So we perform Charpy V notch test. Some of the bridges nowadays, they recommend the European steel, which we get in a market, they call JR, J0, J2, K2, NLML. So JR, R stands for room temperature. So we perform Charpy test at room temperature, 0 degree we perform for 27 joule, J2 we perform at minus 20 degree. So the best steel, like in cold region, we go for NLML, which is tough steel. And reinforced concrete, we have a cube strength 30 MPa, 25 MPa. Fourth topic, which will touch the expansion joint bearing. These are another components of bridge which allow expansion and contraction. So expansion joint, they require maintenance and they make user experience not so good. So nowadays we make continuous slab bridge. So during casting, we will keep girder simply supported. We'll do this casting situ, and that will make our bridge continuous. Yes, we see around nowadays elevated metro corridor. They are bridge, U girder. This picture I have taken from Dubai Metro. Now we will see optimization and cost study of a bridge. So bridge has a superstructure. It can be like simply supported or continuous, and then a pier which supports, and foundation. It can be open foundation or a pile foundation. So this component we call substructure, and this part we call superstructure. So when we start a project, we can do a study, like what will be the span, 30 meter, 50 meter, 70 meter. What is the cost of superstructure? We plot cost of superstructure. And then what is the cost of substructure? We plot against span. Where it meets, we call that as optimum configuration. So when you want to make a continuous long bridge, if your single unit is optimum, economical, the whole length, it is like you save 100 rupees in one unit. So like as you multiply, you will do big saving. So this is how we can come up with what is optimum span. But where you have some navigational requirement, there you have to span bigger. Based on construction method, we can divide bridges into balance cantilever using foam traveler, lifting frame, launching gantry, false work, incremental launching, and full span precast. So now we will touch based on construction technology. So this one is a balance cantilever construction where our foam traveler moves outward from the central pier. This picture I have taken from Basic Construction, Infinity Bridge in Dubai. Many bridges in India we have done using balance cantilever foam traveler. Balance cantilever using lifting frame. Here the lifting frame will lift the segment, precast segment it will keep, and we will go on stressing cable. So in a design at the joint during service, we keep, since these are all the segments which are joined together, tied together, we don't allow any tension during service. This is one of the criteria when we do post tension girder design. Then we have span by span construction using launching entry, where we bring all the segments. They will be suspended from launching gantry. We will pass the cables, stress it, and then that complete span will be ready. So we call span by span construction. This is one of the fastest technology. Complete Dubai Metro, they did using span by span construction launching gantry. Like each segment had a weight of around 49 metric ton. 49 metric ton. another picture of a launching gantry. They had around 9 launching gantry, and complete length of Dubai Metro was around 54 kilometers. Then we have again the form traveler balance cantilever construction. This is a new form of construction. If I have a deep gorges in a forest and I want to cross, I will not able to put any formwork from down. So during this time, we make our girder on one of the bank and just try to push it. So that, but now to make this economical, we put in front steel launching nose. So from here we have a pulling jack. It will pull the girder. So girder will move forward and it will get support here. So only problem with these bridges, now this is this location we have a hogging. As it moves forward, it will be under sagging. So the same segment, like this cross section, during construction it is changing from hogging to sagging. So we have to provide a high amount of pre-stress in this type of bridges, but we save lot of on formwork, false work, and it is safe. We are working from a one of the bank. One of railway bridge for Konkan Railway was built using incremental launching. Another picture of incremental launching. So the length of a launching nose is around 65%, and if you have a big span, we can create a temporary soar in between. Steel soaring to, like, if you here spans are 50 meter, but if you want to span 100 meter, then we can always bring one soaring, temporary soaring in between for incremental launching. Previous picture was showing pull. Here we are doing pushing. One more picture of from Dubai Metro project, where they had pier cap also precast. Only this portion of the center they left for cast in situ, because all the joints should be strong enough, and the pier cap also were pre-stressed. Another view from Saudi Metro, where they used complete span as a one segment, precast U girder, and this slab they could cast on top of it without formwork, precast U girder with cast in situ. So we touch on truss bridge, arch bridge, balance cantilever, portal frame, slab bridge, continuous slab bridge with haunch, and we can do slab bridge. One topic which I didn't touch, we can make hollow slab also. Like when you want to reduce self weight of a slab, we can keep hole in between. So like one of the Mumbai flyover, we use hollow core slab. So pre-stress, like if I have a, so what hollow core does, it reduces its self weight. And we don't require any material at the center. Like as we learned, the moment is getting transferred by push-pull. Till now, any question before we jump into the next topic? Yes. Just let me check our connection. Yes, we are good. So now we will touch into the topic. 1 minute. Cable supported bridge concept. Here I have shown a span of L. So for a cantilever, bending moment will be WL square over 2. WL square over 2, which we use in balanced cantilever construction. If I divide that L into 8 equal parts, like as I said, divide and rule, what will happen with the bending moment? The bending moment became 1 over 768 WL square. So it got reduced from WL square over 2 to 768, around 300, 350 times it has reduced. So when your bending moment reduces, your section self weight will reduce. But we cannot provide any support inside river or sea. I cannot provide this support. So I can take that support up, like instead of providing below, I can take up. So like I wanted support here, I cannot provide because I have a river and I want to give clearance for big ship traveling below. So how we get this support? We put high tension cables which have yield strength of around 1860 megapascal. Normal reinforcement steel which we use in RCC, it has 420 MPa, so it is around 4 times stronger steel. Yes, so we call it as a cable state bridge. Now, what will be the governing criteria for cable state bridge? If I give a steel rod and I tell you to break, you pull it, but you will not able to break. How you can break? The only way to break is by bending it up, down, up, down. So when you do this for maybe say 20, 30 cycle, that bar or a steel rod, it will break. So what brought, like what happened? Like when you bend it down, you have a tension at top. When you bend up, tension at bottom. So that we call fatigue. As human, also like if I get work for 1 week and next week no work, next week more work, no work, what it will make me? Fatigue. I will not able to deliver best of my brain. Same way, our members, they are like us. If you bring fatigue, tension, compression, or more tension, less tension, more tension, less tension, it will fail. In normal bridges, we allow, like when we do RCC design, we allow 0.87 FY, partial safety factor of 1.15. And when we do pre-stress bridges, we allow stress level in a strand 0.7 FP. When you stress at the initial, we can go up to 0.75 FP, but after the losses, like in pre-stress we have a losses we call short-term loss, long-term loss, so the stress level remains 70%. So what stress level we keep in a cables for cable stay bridges, that we will touch now. So when I have a live load on left side, these cables, they will go under tremendous tension. So that value say I call T1. And my live load travels on the other side. So now there is here, there is no tension. I will get tension T2. So you do first stress sigma 1, T1 divided by A, sigma 2, T2 divided by A. So you had sigma 1, which was high tension, and sigma 2, there is no more, like less tension. So this difference, delta sigma, sigma 2 minus sigma 1 governs design in case of cable stay breaches. So this is the only one fundamental. So the first fundamental principle we learned on cable stay breaches, divide and rule. We are dividing our long span into small parts. And since we cannot provide any support, we are taking using cable. So that brings down bending moment close to zero. So here the behavior is axial tension and compression. Like we begin our lecture by telling the in bridges we transfer load by bending shear or axial tension compression. So here axial tension compression. So this should be a most economical. So and this, like now we learned the delta sigma, change in stress. So the code gives like based on your stress range, the delta sigma 140, you should allow how much stress in cable, 45%. If you have stress range 200, we allow 45%. So this is a governing design condition for cable stay breach. The stress variation and allowable stress. So we should not touch beyond 45% of 1860. Worli-Bandra ceiling bridge, which is a cable stayed bridge. Now I will share this, like how we can do optimization of cable stayed bridge. Here I want to tell this cable, which is at the end, it is called backstay. It has a longest length and it will have the longest area required because it will encounter highest stress variation in the bridge, the backstay. So like we call in a human body, heart and brain, same way the backstay. If I call phylon as a heart, this is a brain, backstay. So if you optimize backstay, you will win the project because it is the longest length and the cable stay quantity cost is around 6 to 10 times in India compared to the normal post tension cable cost. So when during my master's study at IIT Bombay, I was at Maharashtra State Road Development Corporation. And I was fortunate to meet a bridge engineer from HNTB who was involved in design of this cable stayed bridge. So this was a initial concept where they had a 500 meter length and expansion joint at this two location, two span symmetrical, 250 meter. And like the client, they wanted to reduce the cost. So how we can do optimization, that was a challenge for HNTB. But as I said, whenever you have a challenge, we are conflict resolver. So what only small modification they did, this expansion joint, they moved from this location to this location. And the total length it became now, instead of 500 meter, 600 meter. So by doing this, like we learn in our strength of material, we have a simply supported bridge. And when you have overhang on one side, we can make overhang also. So what, like by adding overhang, what happens? Your sagging moment getting reduced and it can take around 20%. We can make overhang on either side also, simply supported with overhang. When we lift our pile, precast pile, we lift at two points. So this was, so he did this and he could remove the biggest cable which was required for the project by taking load in this portion by backspan of 50 meter. And like it has a two length, the bridge Worli-Bandra ceiling So you require one cable here, 1, 2, 3, 4, and on the other side 4. So 8 cables, and they had around length of 300, like 260 meter, because 250, and that much quantity could be saved. And yes, the final bridge which we see today, it is with this configuration. So always we should remember what are the constraints. If we understand constraint and what drives the quantity, we can come up with innovative solution. Now I will share case study of Delhi Delhi water supply line from UP Jal Nigam to Janak Vihar. Like, if I'm not wrong, like it, this project Stoop Consultant did during 95-98, and it required around 9 kilometer long viaduct to take water, 270 cubic meter per second. And like, whenever there is a tender, there will be always department design. We call design which is done by department or in the package. So it had a box, a 24 meter unit. So what happens in hydraulics, if you make a section circular, we call hydraulic radius, weighted perimeter divided by area. So if that hydraulic radius is less, it has a less friction losses. So our CEO founder, late CR Alim Chandani, he came up with a solution. Let us make this circular and simply supported with overhang. Like as we saw before, here what happens? Your bending moment diagram becomes hogging and sagging. And like here, as we started, we told, bridge is about design engineer, construction engineer, and authority. So we did collaboration with a construction team contractor. The contractor was NBCC, National Building Construction Company. We told you have to make one set of formwork, and that formwork will be used multiple of time, and you will win the job. He said, yes, I will make that formwork. And now we can see that bridge, like that aqueduct was, they won the job and it has been executed. So we touch on cable state bridge and few concept on how we do optimization. We learned two concept of bridges, balance cantilever and cable state bridges. Like what happens with cable state bridges, we are only allowing putting 45% FY. We are not utilizing full strength due to stress variation. And here we touch 70% balance cantilever construction. So this we can use up to 100, 150 meter, and this will be more than 400 meter span. So in between, can we have some solution which will be economical? Yes, Japanese engineer, he did marriage of cable state and balance cantilever, and he came up with a concept called extra dose bridges, where part load is taken by balance cantilever pre-stress and the remaining by cable. So what happens here? You don't have much stress variation. Your stress variation reduced. So you can touch from 0.45 to 0.6 FP level. So here, this case shows general span arrangement of a cable, extra dose bridges. Now we don't require pylon bigger. In cable state bridges, a pylon is tall. But here we require L over 10. So if I have a 400 meter span, my pylon height will be just 40 meter. And 20% will be taken by balance cantilever. So this we divide complete 400 into 5 segments, 80 meter, 80 meter, 80 meter. And this is a concept of extra dose bridges. So it is a marriage of cable state bridge and balance cantilever construction. नर्मदा ब्रिज इन गुजरात, एक्स्ट्रा डोज ब्रिज, फ्यू मोर पिक्चर फ्रॉम जापान फॉर एक्स्ट्रा डोज ब्रिजेस. सो इट लुक्स एलिगेंट एंड इट इज कॉस्ट इफेक्टिव. सो वी कैन गो फॉर दिस कंसेप्ट अप टू 200 मीटर स्पैन. एंड जापान बींग हीट बाई अर्थक्वेक, दे वॉन्ट टू रिड्यूस सेल्फ वेट ऑफ अ बॉक्स गर्डर. सो इफ यू आई कीप अ कॉन्क्रीट वेब, इट विल एड इन टू ट्रिमेंडस डेड वेट. सो दे केम अप विथ अ कंसेप्ट कॉल कॉरुगेटेड स्टील वेब. सो बाई पुटिंग दिस कॉरुगेटेड स्टील वेब, यू आर रिड्यूसिंग सेल्फ वेट ऑफ अ गर्डर. अनदर पिक्चर ऑफ वन ऑफ अ केबल स्टेट ब्रिज फ्रॉम जापान. हियर ऑल्सो वी कैन सी दे टुक दिस लोड बाई बैक स्पैन 42.525 मीटर, लाइक हाउ वर्ली बांद्रा सी लिंक दे डिड बैक स्पैन. सो वेन यू सी मोर कंसेप्ट यू विल नो आइडियाज वॉट मेड इट इकोनॉमिकल. सो हियर इट वॉज अ टू स्पैन अनसिमेट्रिकल, बट दिस पोर्शन लोअर इट वेंट टू दिस साइड फ्रॉम बैक स्पैनिंग, नॉट थ्रू केबल. नाउ एट द एंड आई विल शेयर सम टिप्स एट यूनिवर्सिटी. वी डिपेंड ओनली ऑन गूगल, वी डिपेंड ऑन अवर प्रोफेसर्स लाइब्रेरी फॉर टेक्निकल मटीरियल, बट एट द फिंगर टिप वॉट वी हैव इट इज अवर मिस्टर गूगल, लाइक सम कॉल मिस्टर गूगल, गुरु गूगल. बट वॉट हैपन्स विथ द गूगल, इट इज लाइक माई वाइफ, वेन आई आस्क वन क्वेश्चन सी गिव्स मी 100 आंसर्स. सेम वे वेन वी आस्क गूगल, से इफ आई आस्क गूगल अबाउट एक्स्ट्रा डोज ब्रिज, इट विल कम अप विथ अ मिलियन रिजल्ट इन अ फ्यू सेकेंड क्विकली. बट वेन वी आर स्टडिंग एंड वेन यू विल ज्वाइन द प्रोफेशनल वर्ल्ड, यू डोंट हैव टाइम टू गो थ्रू ईच सर्च. सो हाउ वी कैन गाइड गूगल टू सर्व वॉट वी वॉन्ट, लाइक नॉट वॉट मिस गूगल वॉन्ट्स टू गिव अस. So what I do, I give clue, site, file type. So if I want to know about extra dose bridges, I will say site JP, Japan. Take all the website in Japan, they will be JP. If I want to know about arch bridges, I will say site RU. So it will search by sitting in Jalandhar. You are telling Google, okay, please serve me some information from Russia, Australia, UK. So if I want to get UK, I will put site UK. If I want from American University, EDU. So by sitting in Jalandhar, we can tell Mrs. Google to search for us from different profile. So here are few clue to put to Google. So if we want to know about Indian Railway, like what are the clauses for bridge design or some specification we want, then we will say site nic.in, because all the information in India, like it will be on nic.in or Indian Railway website. Once you know, you can just tell. And like if you want PDF file, PDF, Excel file, XLS. So these are some clues which we give. Document, PPT, XLS, say list of contractors, list of consultants, list of vendor who supply some item that will be in Excel file. So this way we can make our search more compact. With this, I will share my final wisdom. As a civil engineer, we should keep 3C in our mind. Commitment. First is curiosity. We should be always curious, okay, why this has been done this way. If you keep your curiosity alive, we can innovate and we can give better solution. Curiosity. Commitment. Like when you take some responsibility, give 110%. So that is commitment. And continuous learning. Keep yourself open to continuously learn. And finally, as a civil engineer, we do create, collaborate, and we are conflict resolver. So I will open forum for question and answer. And we will share the soft copy of this presentation also with the student. And one more thing we will do, I will share a question paper on a Google form. I request all the students to attempt, and we will declare winner, and we will give an online gift for our winner. If we have more right answers, we'll create 2-3 more winners, and they will get a prize. So now we keep open for students to ask questions.
Yeah, participant. Now the question session is open to all. Sir, before that, there are few questions already they have marked in the chat box. So
yes, I can.
Yeah, we can start from the bottom, sir. From the last means from the latest one. Mr. Sanjeev Kumar is asking. He was, I think, conducting studies regarding corrugated steel webs in horizontally curved girders. It would be great if you give some more points on corrugated steel webs. So can you please?
Yes. So by doing corrugations, like if you remember our plate girder design, when we require a stiffener, vertical stiffener, horizontal stiffener, by doing corrugation, we are avoiding the stiffener. So it is providing us a stiffness in lateral direction. So sir, question is, I am currently doing studies regarding corrugated steel webs in horizontal curved girders. It would be great if you give some more points on corrugated steel web. So some points which I can add now is corrugated web, it gives stiffness in lateral directions. So whenever we think about plate, its shear resistance is governed by buckling. Like we have in reinforced concrete, we restrict our shear stress based on tensile capacity of concrete. We like if we see the code, we don't allow shear to exceed, the shear is taken by reinforcement, but still we don't allow it to exceed beyond certain limit, because then concrete will fail. Like finally, it's the marriage of concrete and steel. So in corrugated steel web, whenever we think about web, it has a responsibility to take shear. It will be governed by shear. And maybe I can share some guidelines which are published in Japan for design of corrugated steel web. They do, and I will share with Sanjeev sir.
Okay, sir. So the next question, the latest one, Mr. Bhupati Kannur, he have the question, which are the codes to be referred for bridge design apart from IRC-6?
Good question. So we have IRC-18, IRC-21. Now IRC has taken up the limit state design, seeing Euro code. So like internationally, what is good thing happening with the corona, many international firm, they are opening their design office in India. It may be in a Chennai, Kolkata, Mumbai, Delhi, Noida. So different part of all the international firms, they are opening their offices in India. So the other codes which are widely used around the world are ESTO, Euro code for bridges. So for we have IRC, and like when we speak about IRC, we have IRC 6, 18, 21, 78 for foundation.
Okay, sir. Next question from Mr. Yash. Can we provide an expansion joint at the central Pylon?
Very good question. So now to explain theory of expansion joint, I will draw here. So first simple concept, we have a simply supported where we can put expansion, like we will require at expansion joint on the both location, and the objective we want to allow it to tension, like expand or contract. So we provide sliding. And when you have a two span continuous, we provide preferably at the center pin. So it will allow it to expand and contract on either side. So when we go on making continuous, we keep sliding on either side. So it will reduce length of expansion joint.
One more question from same participant, sir. In case of expansion joint, how to provide?
So the most efficient expansion joint is nowadays finger type. We get proprietary product we call finger type expansion joint. How to control vibration in cable street bridges? Yes. So, I will again compare what happens in cable. We call something resonance. If forcing function, let me explain concept of resonance in a slide. So, if I have a cantilever beam, it will be having its own natural frequency. The natural, like human, we have a frequency which comes from two parameters. One we call mass and another called stiffness. So if you have a force, like if some boy is sitting on a swing, he's swinging, and you apply force when it comes, then it will go further away. So that is called resonance. When you're forcing function frequency matches with the frequency of a structure, then small force also will get magnified. So there are techniques like dampers, which we call to reduce, to dissipate that energy. So vibration control dampers we use.
Okay. Sir, there is one more question from Mr. Sanjeev Kumar at 12:25 p.m. What about patch load, which acts from the supports and launching shoes, because nearly all cross-section comes at least once over the support, where a concentrated reaction force acts on the girder ILM? Can you please go through the chat box, sir?
So he has put a question. May I request, sir, just to repeat a question? So I'm with you. Just
yes, sir. What about patch load, which acts from the supports and the launching shoes, because nearly all cross section comes at least once over the support, where a concentrated reaction force acts on the girder, ILM. Yes, sir. This is the
question. Okay. So his question is for incremental launching method. So in incremental launching method, we have a nose, the girder keeps on moving on. So there is a change in stress. The girder, but let me draw a figure to explain the incremental launching concept. So we are at this stage. Here I have a tension now at the support. Tension at this location. So I will mark. So after I cast one more segment, I will push it forward. So this segment will move in the next picture. This will move here. So now this section before it was top tension, now we have got tension at the bottom. So in case of incremental launch bridge design, the always governing condition will be during construction. So did I answer?
I think Mr. Sanjeev, can you hear?
Or maybe like Mr. Sanjeev can unmute and speak.
Yeah, that will be fine. Mr. Sanjeev? Sanjeev Kumar? Okay, I think he's not there, sir. No problems. Sir, I think one more last question. Question from Vikas Kumar. Aeroelastic effect due to wind load, how to control? Aeroelastic effect due to wind load, how to control? Yes, sir. This is the question from Mr. Vikas.
So, like nowadays, the stay cables are supplied by leading companies like VSL, Fresenate. Like this being a specialized topic, they call a vibration, but they provide some detail on a cables which will ensure that they don't go under this local modes of vibration, and local modes doesn't create this vibrations.
Okay.
Yeah, this is a little specialized topic which comes from the cable manufacturers. When we are building, if I remember, in case of a circular section, we have effect drag and out of plane bending, out of bend vibration. Yeah. Okay. It's a specialized question. Yeah.
Okay, sir. Anybody have any questions? Participants, please. You are free to ask. I think there is no questions from the participants, sir. Sir, thank you so much. I think in the beginning there was some interruptions, and I'm very sorry if something which was unfortunate. And I think now let's wind up this session, sir, because second session will start at 3 p.m. So thank you so much for your wonderful presentation, sir. And I'm really thankful to you, and on behalf of organizing committee, I extend my sincere thanks to you for your valuable time, sparing this presentation, sparing your time and the presentation. Now I request all the participants, please join at 2:55 p.m. today after lunch, and because the presentation will start at 3 p.m. on modular steel structures. So we'll wind up this session at this point of time. And sir, shall we close?
Yes, thank you for your attention, all. So the main objective was to connect like what you learn at university, it is a foundation for your success.
Yes, sir. Yeah. Sir, one student's asking, please share Japanese provisions on corrugated steel webs. I think same Sanjeev Kumar.
Yes, sir. I will share.
Okay, sir. Sir, what about that question and answer session for participants and prize distribution? So maybe it attracts.
No, so like after this modular presentation, I will prepare a question paper and say for next session when we are meeting, we will announce our winner. So the it will be an open book exam, so they can always go through the material. We will share the presentation material before along with the question paper on a Google form, and they can attend. Sir.
Okay, sir. Thank you so much, sir. Nice, sir. And participants, I may request all the participants, please fill your feedback form after a second session. So the single link will be used for sending the feedback. So please don't worry. Okay. So now, sir. Now we'll leave the meeting, sir.
Thank you, sir. Thank you. Thank you, students.
Thank you so much, sir. Mm-hmm. Thanks.